C'est bon. It's okay.
Okay, should I start?
Yes, please.
Where should I look? In the camera?
Yeah, in the camera. Yeah, best. Or me or the camera, but okay. Better to explain the yeah. Sometimes it's not very easy because we are not used to, you know.
No, but traditional Swedish food, it has to do with our roots. That's where the base comes from, and the climate we're living in. For example, in the winter, all the lakes used to freeze. So during the summer, where we could fish, we needed to find a way to preserve the fish. So we were smoking it, a lot of smoked salmon, and obviously there was a lot of hard work in the winter as well, and during the summer. When you ate, you needed to be really filled up. So it was quite heavy food, and it's quite a lot of high salt. That's more the tradition, and to use the ingredients that way to preserve them, and in all different kinds of way, pickling, and we use quite a lot of butter as well, and to preserve bread, we used to make hard bread, like called knäckebröd, which you could have over the winter, where you during the winter didn't have any flour, so you couldn't actually bake bread that way. And if I'm looking at more modern food today in Sweden, and what we're doing, we're trying to work more with the seasons. Also now, when we actually could go fishing, even though it's winter, we don't need to smoke and pickle so much things. As long as we follow the seasons really hard, there's a huge variety of food and ingredients over the whole year. And we have lightened it up, really. And there are some things that it used to be all French or German and Austrian head chefs in Sweden working 10, 15, 20, 30 years ago. And then there was this young generation who went out and worked in different restaurants during Europe, in Spain, in France, in Italy, like me, René Redzepi, and so on, so on. And we came back to our home cities and home countries and said, stop, let's take a different direction now, let's try to do something different. Let's not cook French food that way, or let's do it our way. And obviously, that's what we do now. And we're not only using parsley and tarragon, we're trying to use other herbs. And I think that's what's also makes it unique, because it's also challenging and new for us as chefs, as we work with these ingredients, because when we grew up, no one used them. So it's a challenge, and it's very, very rewarding when you success with it, really. That's the sort of the story of traditional food and modern cuisine in the Scandinavian era at the moment. Obviously also there's big difference in Danish or Norwegian or Finnish and Swedish traditional food, but especially with the countries more north, Sweden, Finland, and Norway, they are more following the same path than, for example, Denmark. So that what you could expect if you go there. You happy?
You know a chef that the name is, he's in Finland, and his name is Sasu Laukonen.
Sorry,
my pronunciation is
Laukonen. Yeah, I know.
Normally I'm going to Finland in June.
His name is Mrs. Sommelier.
The restaurant. And normally I'm going in,